Hey there, baseball fans, it's Ben, and I'm back with more from this collection I bought. It's really not a whole collection, it's just a single box of cards, mostly vintage, which is why I bought it, or I should say 70s, not old vintage. But I've just been blown away by the surprise rookies that have come in this box, including a Jack Morris rookie, Eddie Murray rookie, etc. So just super, super pleased with it. So now I'm into these side ones, which I think are mostly going to be 86 tops or 80 junk wax kind of stuff. But I'm more than happy to have bought this box, even just for the ones I've pulled so far. So anything else that comes out is just a bonus. There's a random David Cone from 97 tops. Yeah, so we're going to shift these out. I like to kind of put aside anything that's 86 and prior in one pile, and then anything more modern than that, kind of another. So I'm really not expecting to see much in here. I'm gonna go through pretty quick, and we'll see if we can find anything that's worth talking about. 86 tops doesn't leave us a whole lot of interesting things. 87 Fleer certainly does not either. Puzzle piece, always like that. Hopefully we can find one or two surprises out of here, though. That would be nice. Like I said, I'm already feeling Razor Shines. Who is Razor Shines, and why have I never heard of this person or seen this card before? I'll have to look him up later. That is, if anybody knows anything about Razor Shines, please let me know. Don't recall ever seeing that name before, seeing that card before. There's Bill Mooneyham, who I know is a gym teacher. These days, one of his students commented on my previous videos, or Keith Hernandez, I'll take that, and mentioned that Bill Mooneyham was a gym teacher for him. So a couple puzzle pieces there. I'll probably skip pretty quickly through these 86 tops since they're all over the place, and I'm not expecting to see a whole lot of them. Even if we did find some good names in here, it's just 86 tops. Looks like there might be separated by teams too. There's a Ted Simmons, he's a Hall of Famer. So 86 tops and 87 Fleer is the name of the game here. Seems like. Just see if we can find anything of interest here. Like I said, these are all gonna be 86 tops, so we'll just fly through those. Keep getting that Ted Simmons. I'm sure there's some stuff in here that we'll find interesting, but no sense in boring. It looks like we got some 86 tops traded in here too. Yeah, these are all sorted by team, it looks like. I'll pull these 87s out of here. And they're all back and forth. I wonder if they were in binders or something that would have made them be every which way. Oh, there's a Don Sutton, 87 Donruss. He's a, or 87 Fleer, he's a Hall of Famer. There's a Dwight Gooden, 86 tops. Not a Hall of Famer, but certainly having as good a 3 or 4 year run as a pitcher has ever had, as far as I'm concerned. All right, so those 86s are, maybe we're done with the 86s for a while. Nope, we're not. More 86s. All the 86s. All the 86s. And then we got a couple puzzle pieces here. 87, 87, 87, 87, 87, 87. And there's that Razor Shines again. I'm absolutely gonna have to look him up. Pendleton second year card. More 86s. There's a Phil Niekro, he's a Hall of Famer. 89. randomly in there. Frank Robinson. Sticker. Sticker from Fleer. Lee Smith. Hall of Fame pitcher right there. I am pretty sure I'll be able to put together a nice partial set of 86 tops from this collection. I'd be surprised if I didn't have them all except for the stars. So we got some 82 Fleer here, but nothing terribly interesting. It looks like there's a J.R. Richard. I like to pull him out again. A good run by him. If you look at that 2021 season there, and then all kinds of strikeouts, two 300 strikeout seasons. He was done pretty dirty by the Astros, if you ask me. So check out the J.R. Richards story if you get a chance. All right, so we got some 85 Donruss. There's Razor Shines again, 85 Donruss. To 88 Donruss, we can get rid of these. There's a Cal Ripken, Ken Griffey Sr., Lenny Dykstra. Did he have an 86 Topps rookie? I'm not sure if he did or not. Might have been a Topps traded in 86. There's an Ozzie Smith, Ruben Sierra, Tim Raines, Jose Canseco, Don Mattingly, Wade Boggs. These are all players that I can make little player collections of. Let me get into our 86, 85, 87. Doug Drabrick, Bobby Thigpen, some more puzzle pieces. Yeah, we're all over the place here, but nothing terribly exciting. Fred McGriff, new Hall of Famer. Oh, and then a random 1976 Topps Rod Carew with Fred Lynn and Thurman Munson. That's cool. Weird that it's in with these other cards. Would have made a lot more sense in the previous two rows I looked at. Much John Smiley, Mitch Williams. '87 Donruss, rated rookie there for Bruce Fields, Bob Horner. Mike Morgan. I'm really looking forward to just cleaning this box out because it's got a lot of junk in it. There's a Keith Hernandez, I like to pull those out. Puzzle piece. '87 Fleer. There, Willie Mays, 86 Turn Back the Clock. More puzzle pieces. And then some 89 Upper Deck. What if we just pulled a Griffey out of here? That'd be great. Not likely. But you never can tell. A lot of rookies actually in the 89 Upper Deck set. Randy Johnson, Dante Bichette, Ken Griffey Sr. Looks like it's just gonna be more of the same here. So I'll fly through these real quick. I don't see anything exciting happening. Maybe we'll get another one of those random 70s cards like that Rod Carew. No. Puzzle pieces here. So these are probably just packs that someone opened, was looking for something, and threw all the rest in here. That's my guess. Hey, there's a Barry Larkin rookie. Dime a dozen, but still a Hall of Fame rookie card. Nothing to complain about. There's a Ryan Sandberg for my PC. There's an Oral Hershiser rookie card too, right? 85 was his rookie year. I'll take that one. Andre Dawson, Dave Winfield, Dale Murphy, Steve Garvey, Dave Parker. Strange little pleasure. Randy Johnson, 1990 Bowman, Vinny Santiago rookie card, Kirby Puckett, Gary Carter. So some random stars thrown in there, and then back to some junk wax. So just the oddest little collection here. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed that one. It was a little strange, and we got one more round to go. I'll see you then.